Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Ray Almgren.
Good morning. Good morning and welcome to day three of NIWeek. This week we have seen some awe-inspiring examples of how graphical system design is truly accelerating innovation and discovery. On Tuesday, the laser cataract application, seeing how Qualcomm has increased their test time by 200x. Then yesterday, the researchers with the anomalous heat effect, Robert Swan and Planet and I, and then the wonderful application from the team from Kyoto with radiation monitoring. But you know, these are just a few of the thousands of really hard problems that our customers are tackling every day, both on and off the planet. But that's why we became scientists and engineers, right? Not because it's easy, but because it's hard. Let's take a look at a really hard problem that one of our customers slayed earlier this summer that generated a lot of headlines.
Five, four, three, two, one, zero.
Stage one.
We have liftoff of the Falcon 9. Falcon 9 has cleared the tower. Starting pitch kick. Yeah, the power systems are nominal.
Set to turn.
Dragon solar array deployment.
Solar array has deployed.
Initiating the capture of the Dragon. Standing by. Capture is confirmed.
A Houston Station, looks like we got us a Dragon by the tail.
I spent quite a bit of time poking around in here this morning, just looking at the engineering and the layout, and I'm very pleased. So flying up in a human-rated Dragon is not going to be an issue.
Check out all of those LabVIEW front panels in SpaceX Mission Control. How cool is that? Now, we're very fortunate today. We have a number of the SpaceX engineers here in the audience, but before I recognize them, I want to congratulate them. Last Friday, the announcement came out that they were awarded the contract for a manned spacecraft to launch in 2015 based on the success of this mission. Congratulations. You know, that's one of the reasons I love being an engineer here at NI. You know, because every day we get to interact with over 35,000 organizations that are doing everything from developing life-saving or eye-saving medical devices to coming up with sustainable and affordable sources of energy. You know, changing the world is a pretty exciting thing. You know, we know that, and our future innovators know that too. So what made you go down this path? I bet many of you can trace your decision to be a scientist or an engineer to this speech delivered right here in Texas.
We choose to go to the moon in this decade and do the other things, not because they are easy, but because they are hard.
Today, it's organizations like SpaceX and Tesla and CERN, using our tools, who recently discovered the ever-elusive Higgs boson God particle, that are providing the inspiration for tomorrow's scientists and engineers. The problem, though, is that somewhere between dropping our kids off at kindergarten and sending them to college, we somehow managed to extinguish their interest in science and engineering. So how does this happen? Well, there's a fundamental disconnect between how we do science and engineering in the real world and how it's taught in the classroom. Not all, but too many educators are pulling a bait and switch on our brightest minds by taking away the hands-on exciting projects that got them interested in the first place and replacing it with a theory-only, math-based approach that is literally driving out our future innovators in droves. This is a dilemma the New York Times recently labeled the Math Science Death March. We've got them. We've hooked them. But we've got to find a way to keep them, or we're in real danger. Every time a student abandons engineering for a more interesting or relevant major, we risk losing the future innovator that will one day cure cancer, or the scientist that will solve the clean water crisis, or the engineer that will discover affordable and sustainable energy. There's got to be a better way, and we've got to find it. Now, there is some good news, though. There are a number of engineering schools and universities that have found a better way. By increasing collaboration with industry, they're able to put hands-on projects into their career learning much earlier in their degree path. These students that are in these programs aren't just doing math, they're doing engineering. So by engaging these students with these real, hands-on, relevant projects early in their curriculum and matching it with a very important theory that they can learn either online or in the classroom, we are keeping the students in the program and equipping them with the resume-ready skills they need to conquer the challenges of tomorrow. Today, we're going to hear from three schools that are doing just that.